CTV News at 6 with Hudson Mack.
Good evening. Thanks for being here. We begin this hour with a life and death struggle that may be playing out in your backyard right now, and it's enough to make your skin crawl. If you have fruit trees, they are likely creeping their way through those leaves with hundreds or maybe thousands of them, tent caterpillars. They devour the leaves, they climb up the side of your house, and if they're out in your patio, you might even have one drop into your hair. But as CTV's Andrew Johnson shows us tonight, homeowners are not the only ones trying to kill them off.
I think they're disgusting. And they're eating everything.
The poor tent caterpillar isn't very popular. Maybe it's because their favorite food is the fruit tree in your backyard.
Well, it's just decimated. If there's nothing left.
Or maybe it's because their nests or tents look like they're covered in hundreds of hairy, squirming little snakes.
They are kind of gross. It's not like when you were a kid.
No, it's not. And so most people set out to solve the problem.
Carefully pruned it off, bagged them, and I sprayed the tree with a safer solution. And it doesn't seem to have worked.
This is the caterpillar, the weapon of choice.
Well, if you have a blowtorch, some duct tape, and a fishing rod lying around.
He just gets up there with the ladder and torches them.
It may not be entirely safe, but her husband might be onto something. Their backyard is now clear of caterpillars, besides the odd straggler.
And now the neighbor's doing it. So they're both out there on their ladders with their propane tanks, killing nests.
If you're not so keen on pulling out the blowtorch, there is a legal natural pesticide spray you can use to take care of your fuzzy problem. It's called BTK. It's found naturally in soil, and it does not agree with a tent caterpillar's stomach.
That's that little tiny white dot right there.
It only gets worse for the tent caterpillar. Homeowners can only dream of the gruesome method of execution carried out daily by tiny flies.
It lays its eggs on the back of the caterpillar, and then the eggs hatch, and the larva burrow their way into the caterpillar and eat the insides out, killing it. And then they lay their eggs inside the corpse.
Hook says the power struggle between the caterpillar and the fly follows a 7-year cycle. The caterpillar population is peaking and will likely now begin to fall for a few years.
So I don't even know if I'm going to have any fruit this year.
As for this spring's crop, don't worry, they'll be curled up in cocoons in just a couple of weeks. By summer, your problem will have flown away. Andrew Johnson, CTV News, Victoria.